Today I want to talk about a passage of scripture that I really like. It's in the book of James, a real practical book in the New Testament. It's kind of toward the end of the New Testament. And this book was written by the Apostle James to a bunch of Christians. And like I say, it's a very practical book about how to live out your Christian faith and actually live what you say you believe. And it's pretty cool. And I love this verse. The verse says, finally, know this, brothers, or finally, brothers, let every person be quick to listen, or quick to hear, slow to speak, and slow to become angry. That's a great concept, which is actually impossible without the power of the Holy Spirit working in your life. And everything we have and everything we live out, if we don't recognize it comes from God, then it's pretty worthless, because everything we do in our own strength for God, Bible says, doesn't mean much. But when we do it in obedience to Him, and in Him filling us with His Holy Spirit, we're filled with the Holy Spirit when we believe, but trusting Him to give us what we need, it's pretty powerful. Now, this looks like a cartoon character, maybe a Cartoon Network, but it's actually it's going to help me. What's the word? Live out this verse, show this verse, okay? All right, so when I twisted it in, like, now, I call this a brain on a stick. That's how my brain works, okay? And are you listening? Are you quick to listen? Because, you know, so many times, you know, we're usually guilty of wanting to talk before you actually really listen. And not only to people, but to God, right? We come to God so many times, we're just like, help me, I need this, I need that, which is cool. He loves hearing our requests. But what He wants for us to do is listen. Finally, brothers, everyone be quick to listen. Listen to what God is saying. Listen to what other people are saying. Part of faith is trusting that God is going to take care of a situation. And I don't have to just jump in and start trying to fix things. That's part of our faith, is saying, oh, wait a minute, I recognize God's in this. Okay, I'm going to do a little something here. Oh, okay, that's cool, huh? And I call this, some of you might know this, you've seen me before. I call this a worm eating a cheeseburger. But, honestly, what I love about this little sculpture is that I can turn it into someone to help me talk. Hi, Mr. Hand.
How you doing?
And Mr. Hand knows what it means to be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to become angry. Yeah. Sometimes we get angry, don't we, Mr. Hand? Yeah. Like when people do things that frustrate us, or somebody, we don't get what we want, or, you know, those things get us frustrated. But the Bible tells us, if we're trusting Jesus, if we're allowing Him to work and move in our hearts, that we've said, Lord, take over my life. He said He promised to give us what we need to be slow to become angry, to be patient. In fact, that's one of the fruit of the Holy Spirit, isn't it?
Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, self-control.
Yeah.
Love, joy, peace, patience.
That's right. Patience is one of the fruit of the Holy Spirit as He's working. Okay, now I'm going to take the brain on a stick, and I'm going to take Mr. Hand, and I'm going to combine them together. And put Mr. Hand on the brain on a stick, and you come out with the snail, Mr. Snail. Okay. This is a great balloon for reminding us that the Bible tells us that everyone, all brothers and sisters, I mean people who are believers, because we have a resource from God, His Spirit, who's moving and working in our hearts, that will produce that love, joy, peace, patience, kindness. You know, snails are known for being really slow. You know, the Bible says be quick to listen, slow to speak. Not so quick to jump in and give your opinion or to make things happen or try to get your way, but be patient and let God move in this. Try to listen to Him and let Him guide you so that you can be doing what He wants you to do rather than what you're trying to do. That's a great principle of spiritual growth and becoming more like Christ, is allowing God to direct us in this way. Hallelujah.